Hello everyone, my name is Iris Franz, 我叫林婉如. Today we're going to talk about backbending labor supply. Bottom line first, if your wage level is W1 the lowest, your labor supply is L1, so you work L1 hours. Now, if your wage rate increases from W1 to W2, you are going to work more hours, and the labor hours is going to increase from L1 to L2. Now, if your wage continues to increase to W3, then you are going to work less than before, so you're going to reduce your labor hours. So you can see that your labor supply curve is backbending, and I'm going to explain why. So we're going to continue with our scenario from last time in Variance book, where we have two things we like to consume. One is leisure and one is consumption. Remember, the cost of leisure is exactly your wage, because for each hour you spend on leisure, you will have to give up your wage. So that's the price of wage, that's W, and the price of consumption is normalized to P, and therefore the slope of your budget line is equal to negative W over P. Now we're going to start with the lowest wage level, W1. So here is your W1, and you can sketch your budget line that goes through your initial endowment, where, remember, you have R bar hours to spend, so 16 hours, and your endowment consumption is C bar. Now, with that wage level, you are going to choose the combination of leisure and consumption at point A, where your leisure hours is R1 and consumption is C1. Notice that when your leisure is R1 hours, that means you spend L1 hours to work. L1 is equal to R bar minus R1. So that's that many hours of labor hours. And suppose at this time our wage is going to increase from W1 to W2. So that is going to change the slope of our budget line from the red line to the blue line. Now at this point, your substitution effect is going to kick in. So when your wage level goes up, that means for each hour of leisure, you will have to give up more wage. Then that means the leisure becomes more expensive. Now, in the earlier chapters, you learned that if you have two goods, good one and good two, if good one becomes more expensive, then substitution effect is going to tell you to buy more good two to replace good one. Likewise, when your wage rate goes up, that means leisure becomes more expensive. So you should have more consumption to replace leisure. Therefore, you are going to consume less leisure. Notice at point B, your leisure is only R2 hours, and you're going to consume more consumption at point C2. And therefore, when you leisure fewer hours, that means you work more hours. So on your labor supply curve, you can see that at wage level W2, you are going to work more hours. You're going to work L2 hours. And therefore, at this point, your labor supply curve is still positively sloped. Now, suppose our wage continues to increase from W2 to W3. Now, you can see our budget line is now a lot steeper than before. And you're going to choose point D. Notice at point D, you have more leisure than point B. You also have more consumption than point B. Why is that? Because both leisure and consumption are the things that we like. And at this point, when our wage goes up to W3, income effect is going to kick in. And therefore, you say, I like leisure, I like consumption, so I'm going to consume both of them a little bit more than before. So you can see C3 is higher than C2, we have more consumption. R3 is higher than R2, we have more leisure. Now, if you have more leisure, that means the work hour will become fewer. So you can see that L3 is less than L2. Why? Because R3 is bigger than R2. So that's the reason why we have a backbending labor supply curve. I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time.